Welcome to Skill-Based Art, a learning resource for art students and artist teachers. My name's Vicki Sullivan and today I'll be doing an oil painting demonstration of a floral still life, and I'll be using a wet into wet method called a la prima. Basically, this is a direct approach and you painting into a wet ground of paint, establishing values and drawing and as I go, all in one go. It's an Italian phrase meaning all in one go. I'll be using a full palette with my paint. I've got titanium white, lead white, Naples yellow reddish. I've got rose pale for the center of these lovely roses here. I've got permanent carmine, permanent rose. I'm trying out a couple of new greens today, transparent yellow green and permanent green maybe for the leaves. And I find this colour, Flinders Blue Violet, which is an art spectrum colour, really useful. And also the Old Holland Violet Grey makes some really nice grey. If I sort of neutralise it with a bit of the Naples yellow, it's really lovely. And I've got the transparent brown oxide, which is great, and a bit of burnt sienna. So we'll see. If I need any other colours, I'll tell you. And my brushes, I love rosemary brushes. They're just the best. And I really like the Master's Choice long flats and long filberts. And sometimes I use some of their other brushes as well, but for some of the more fine detail, but I'll talk about that as I use them because I'm not sure until I'm using them what I'll need. Okay, thanks. I'm just starting off with a little wash of burnt sienna with odorless mineral spirits for the wash, just to warm the canvas up a little bit, the linen up from underneath. And my board is just a bit of linen on that I've glued onto some board because I like that sort of surface, so I just wash it in and then I rub it back so it's got a bit of just warm up the linen a little bit from underneath. And then I sort of usually try and figure out what the center of the roses is. I might just turn them around a little bit more. So that beautiful sort of rich orangey sort of colour. So I'm going to try and mix something that'll work like that, which could be a bit of the rose, the pale rose, with maybe a bit of Naples yellow reddish, perhaps. And that looks pretty good. I might put a bit of Naples yellow with it, yellow it up a little bit more. Very rich, deep. I might whack a bit of permanent rose in there. And a bit more yellow. Keep the pale rose for the more subtle pink. I might even go a bit darker and put the carmine with a bit of yellow. Might have gone in a little bit too deep, but that's okay because I can, it's quite deep on the inside of that center of the rose. So then I kind of basically just do a bit of a wash in with the OMS so it's a thin sort of wash just to sort of get my placement. So this one's the focal point, even though this one's a really lovely supporting one. So I'll probably put this one in the middle. And this is all going to be really light and pale. And then this one over here. This has got quite big. Normally I do sight size, but lately I've just been mucking around and just sort of not measuring as much, just sort of going on shapes and just doing sort of conceptual spheres more. I don't know how to explain that. Okay, so there's sort of a roughish outline, and I'll paint the background back into that and rub out maybe if I'm doing little buds and leaves and that. I'm not sure if I'll end up doing those other two, because we'll see how I go with these first. So then I'll probably use a bit thicker, so some of that of the carmine and a bit more of the yellow. To really set up that centre colour. It's really beautiful, actually. Deep centre. Normally I just do one at a time, but I just feel like while I've got that, you know, that is a bit more orange. I kind of want to sort of establish that as well. So I'm sort of squinting and just establishing a little bit of the rough shape of that shadow in the centre of both roses. And now just sort of concentrate on this one, I think. Try and get one done. Okay, and then I might, it's got these beautiful sort of paley greys. So on the outside petals. So what I might do is mix up a bit of the Old Holland blue violet. Violet grey, actually. Blue violet. And sort of put in with that a little bit of the Naples yellow. I might even stick a bit of the Naples yellow reddish to warm it up a little. And that will make a really pretty grey. It's almost a greeny grey though, so I might stick a bit more yellow in. A very soft grey. Now that's sort of similar. So I'm just holding it up on the palette and just, I mean, you can't really tell until it's on the page, on the canvas, but sometimes just holding it up just to see how it's looking isn't a bad idea. And the other thing, to make it a bit darker, a little bit of Flinders Blue Violet just tips it into that bluer. But it's quite warm as well. Warm blue. Probably needs a little bit more yellow. It's getting there. It's probably a tad darker, so I'll stick a bit more of the Flinders Blue Violet. And I might just sample that on the. And so now I'll be using the linseed oil as my medium. Oops, and then I spilled it. Great. So basically that those lovely greys come all around here. I'm just sort of really being really loose and roughing it in at the moment.
trying not to get detail, but just to sort of keep it sort of conceptual. So just getting the roundedness, the round of the and the outlining shapes of it sort of happening. And stick a bit of this shadow shape in here because it's all sort of blending together a bit with the roses touching each other. Just a little bit, just to get the basic shape. And they're really lovely soft greys, like the colour of a galah. Some of these lovely greys sort of in there as well, but they're not, you know, some of them are pretty deep, aren't they? Having trouble squinting. Now, I'm going to try and mix up a bit of the paler, very pale pinks that define some of the petals. Or maybe I'll mix up some of this greens in the background. That might be a good thing to do, actually. Use a bit of this green umber if you don't see enough. And maybe a bit of the transparent yellow green as well. I haven't put any viridian out, but I think I might need to because it's a very green of it. I don't think I'm doing enough without viridian. I like to have a lot of brown in the greens. They just look a lot more real when they've got more brown in them. And just sort of loosely put in some of this shape. It's not dark enough, but maybe I can deal with that later. Maybe put some transparent oxide brown in with the green to get it darker. Yeah, that's nice with the viridian actually. This transparent oxide brown is really lovely with the viridian. It makes it beautiful, beautiful colours. Yeah. This will make a little outline for that bud there, because that's quite pretty. And then I was thinking of doing the brown for the background. I might just stick a bit of that in just so I can, it can just help me. Establish the lights once you've got the darks established, it sort of helps to be able to see how light you need to go. It's hard to judge if you're working on white. Dark enough, so I actually have some mauve there. I might stick that in with my brown and see if I can make a really deep dark colour there for the background. Because these parts under here are very, very dark. Yeah, that's nice. I don't want to go too close to the edge either, because I don't want my whites contaminated, so I'm just sort of roughing it in, basically. This is sort of like a blocking, really. And you don't want to contaminate your darks with your light colours, or they go all milky and chalky. And they're such beautiful, transparent colours, the darks, that it's nice to keep them that way, if possible, for as long as possible. I probably shouldn't have done that. I probably should have left that for the white rose, but I think two roses is probably enough. I can always rub it out if I have to. It's always good to get back and check your tonal values, which I can't really tell at the moment because there's not enough background filled in. But it's nice to sort of get rid of a lot of that and get rid of the stark white so you're not glared out by it. Maybe I will leave a bit of that. I might just rub out some of that brown, just in case I want to just maybe add a bit of that white rose there, so I can just dip the rag in odorless mineral spirits and run a bit of it out on that spot, because you don't want it to contaminate your lights. There, that'll be okay. just in case. Brush of this, really, now that I've got all the little bits in. I feel like adding a bit more green, suggesting a bit more green down below here, even though there's not really any there, just sort of balance it a bit better. Dark white glaring out my eyes, which helps a lot. Right, and I might stick a bit of those greys here. They're even cooler, so maybe a bit more of the beautiful Old Holland, which is quite cool. It's almost a little bit greener. Yeah, that's better. Dirtied my brush now, so I'm going to get some tin of lavender essence that I've been washing my brushes in, and a bit of a rinse to get the contamination of the brown out of the grey, because I don't want it contaminating my whole picture. There is a bit, it's good to blend it a bit, but I don't want it to take over, which it could do if I leave it. Okay, so now that kind of comes in and around there more. Hmm.
I'm going to mix some creams into this grey. Oh, oops, I had a dirty palette on my head. That's silly. And so that's going to go into some of this nice grey. And I try and use a different brush for each tone and colour so that I don't contaminate my paint. So, let me see. It's going to have to be much lighter. I might even go in with a bit of titanium as well, so I'm sort of mixing my whites a bit, which see how it goes. That's such a bright little edge there. What I might need to do is mix up some really pale pinks now. Using some of this beautiful pale rose. I really like that. It's so subtle. But it does have a bit of the orange in it, so I'm putting a bit of Naples yellow reddish in as well. And I'm mixing a bit of linseed oil in with the paint. Naples yellow as reddish is notoriously thick. Well, the tube I've got is, so I'm going to make it a bit more buttery to use, really. Okay, so let's see what this is like. Mm.
some paper towel so I can sort of wipe off my brush in between each stroke, and that might just help me lay on nice thick. I'm trying to lay down one brush stroke at a time and get it right. And I'm a little bit nervous doing it in front of the camera as well, so. I think I need a bit more white in this mixture. I'm going to get another brush. Really liking these really little rosemary brush, Master's Choice, size 1 and 2. They're just really useful for these tiny little petals. So, let me see. Kind of comes down. I'm just trying to get the sphere shape kind of happening. And these are very intricate roses too. I think it's a David Austin rose, and it's called Earth Angel. And they're really beautiful rose. It's its first, I've just been growing them this year, and it's the first season of flowering. We've had lots of flowers on them. I think it's really nice to grow your own flowers to paint, because then you've got them fresh and you don't have to go down the shop to get them in the morning, and you know, you can just pick them straight out of the garden early in the morning when they're at their best. And just get them when they're ripe to paint. Now there's that outer petal here. It's got quite a bit of light happening on it. It's a really slow process, just slowly building up all the layers of petals. And it's got all these sort of really pale greys. So I might mix up some more, get some more white out and do some really pale greys there around the other side. Could probably mix a bit of that pale pink into the pale grey. Where the colours sort of blend a bit. And it's got that nice pale pink. So I'm going to put some darker colours in there. Okay, so there's a bit of dark here. Another bit of dark edging shadow coming out of there. Not quite sure about my temperature. Tonally it looks right, but it's not quite right temperature-wise, I think. Needs a bit more neutralizing, so if I stick a bit of yellow. Right. Oh, the other thing I could probably try is a bit of raw sienna, maybe. Yeah, that tips it. Raw sienna and the Flinders Blue Violet are sort of help neutralize each other, and they make a sort of nice grey when they mix with white. I'm gonna stick a bit more of that in. And that kind of goes all the way. Good thing with oil is if you muck it up, you can always rub it off with a rag and re-establish better. Yeah, I'm definitely happier with that than what I had. There's something though, I think I need to get a small brush. Small flat downs. And get my brown. And change this shape a bit. Still seems way too purple. I think I need to rub out a little bit there. This is quite nice for some of the shadows in the flower. Even, let me see. That petal is way too big. Thank you. The nice thing about the lead white is it kind of sets up nice and quickly, and you know, once you sort of can get into the flow and start getting the petals in, it does give you this sort of nice texture, which I really like. But you have to be very careful not to get it on your skin and to dispose of it properly. Starting to build up some petals in the centre of the rose. Now sort of got some of the shape established. The thing about the roses is you're chasing them all day as they move, which is kind of crazy, but it can't be helped. They love the light, so they, as you're painting, they're opening the petals, their petals. Finally see it starting to get somewhere. These Master's Choice filbert size zeros are really nice for doing the really little fiddly bits. Just laying in a bit of edge of a petal or something. The petals around the outside look cooler to me, where the shadows are. And so I'm going back into my greys, grey sort of creamy mixtures to start establishing the outer petals. Look, I'm struggling with that petal, it's tricky. I need to establish that outer petal to really sort of get the correct shape. And I'm just going to rub out a bit to be able to see if I can get that shape and then lay in the lights. Mm-hmm. It's a pretty high key white happening on that reflected surface just here. very, very pale pink for this. It's nice when you get round to attending to the bits of the drawing that finally the shape starts to look like the rose instead of being a great big muddle. So they're just bits of it are starting to take shape now. It's taken me ages to get get to that point this time. Starting to feel a bit happier about it. Not everywhere, but like I'm getting lost in all the petals now. Probably need a coffee. Trying to really hit that with a really, really bright white because it's the light is coming from there, and that is probably the lightest bit of the flower. And even in under here I've probably made that a little bit too dark, the shadow falls. Being the lightest bit of the flower, the shadow's lighter. some of these darks in around. Just I love the drama of the lovely pastely creamy roses against the dark of the background. It's really quite lovely, the contrast. It's great. This transparent oxide brown is a really lovely colour. Bit of drama happening there. So, okay, I might try and start working on the flower in the background, which is a bit subordinate, but it's so pretty. It's still part of the focal point, sort of. So I'm gonna have to figure that out, how to deal with it. Maybe a bit of a bigger brush, and I'll start putting in some of the pale greys, perhaps. Mix some of the warm petal colour with my grey. Oh yeah, that kind of works. Because these petals in here, the shadow is sort of a warmish shadow, I think. I'm gonna have to get back a lot so I can really stop getting lost in the petals. When you get back, you can simplify the shapes, and it's easier to see what you need to do next. And when you're up close, you see so much detail that it's really hard to decipher what you need to do. So, for instance, that. Looks kind of nice. When I get back, I can sort of see this beautiful shadow here. And a beautiful shadow here, so I'm trying to establish those to establish the form. And with the form, you get the character of the rose. That nice little bit of shadow in there. Stick a bit of that in. And then I'm going to get my rag and I'm going to rub out a little bit of this area so that my lights will become nice and creamy white sort of thing. One of my favourite flower painters is Henry Fanton Latour. And I saw a fantastic exhibition of his flowers in Spain at the Prado a long time ago, in about 2009. And I wish we had some more Henry Fanton Latours at the gallery in Melbourne so that we could, you know, go and see them. They're so amazing. He was probably the greatest flower painter ever, I think. So mainly the brushes I've been using are mainly the Master's Choice size 2 flats, long flats for this. They just seem to be the right size that I feel like using today for this.
another 10 of those Rosemary's Choice size 2s today. They're just what I want. I'm going to mix a bit of grey with a bit of this pale pink for some of the petals. Let's see how that goes. Not sure about that. Let me see. This is always the part where I feel like it gets lost. And it's a slow trip to find your way to the right strokes. Trying to establish this colour in the centre, so I'm sort of mixing a bit of my grey in with a bit of this lovely orangey crimsony colour to just get that sort of dark warm shadow colour. It's a tricky one to get, actually, to find.
Should I get the right mixture between the grey and the warm orange? That's a bit of a challenge for me. And this is where I need to get my rag out again and just wipe back. Just to stop that colour getting muddy. To see it taking shape slowly. I might just try and to find some of these shapes using the background colour to cut in to the creams. Frill across here happening. So that would be some light little suggestions of and
They really are gorgeous roses. These ones. Now my little buds have sunken down behind. So it's a bit of a shame because I wanted to paint them, but maybe I can use that as my model and just paint it twice. That might be the go. So I might just sort of pop that in now. This really lovely, what's it called again? Permanent green light, which is a really great colour. So I'm going to mix it with a couple of these other colours, but it really packs a punch. I might just put a bit of burnt sienna in with it to sort of knock it back a little. That doesn't really work. Hang on. Maybe I'll put a bit of transparent green oxide. Yeah, that's better. To knock it back a bit. And then I'm going to get another brush. And just sort of try and intimate a little rosebud with a few strokes. Maybe that with a bit of this Naples yellow reddish, Naples yellow I mean, could be just the ticket to the top of the bud. Area here. So that when I slash in my little bit of apricot, it's not going to get overwhelmed with the green. Pop a bit of pink in there, a bit more Naples yellow reddish, and try and keep a steady hand. Not bad. But it probably needs a little bit of tweaking. Okay.
can see this lovely little bit of light coming through the back of that rose there, so I quite like that. So I'm going to stick that in. See this really, really, really light petal there that I kind of haven't really established yet. And there's another one coming out here. I'll have to put that nice purple shadow in there. Yeah, I hope I didn't just contaminate my white brush. And there's quite a deep shadow under here. Right, under here. Yeah. Which. It's a bit off, something's wrong there. Maybe I need to put some more of these. Yeah. Yep. Nice dark thing up there too now. Not sure how I managed to do that, but I might have to re-establish kind of warm passages. Too warm now. I need to grey it down a little.
Okay, it's starting to, I'm starting to see the form evolving a little bit better now, which is a relief. I'm just trying to build up the lights a little bit more around the form to really show the, where the light's hitting better. And that's what this lead white's really good for, because it's so thick. And when you're building up the lights, the thickness actually helps it look even lighter. And it takes the colour very nicely as well, so. Another bud. I might make this bud a closed bud. Mm.
just cut back in around it with the dark. And now do a bit of work on that other leaf, this one. Getting there. Now I'm just going to really loosely describe this rose at the back, because that's not the focal point, but it's kind of nice compositionally. So let me think about that. I might need a big brush for starters. Something like that maybe. And this nice dark sort of passage under here. Actually, it almost looks a little bit greeny blue over the back there, so I don't know whether my eyes are going funny or it really is, but I'm going to try a bit of viridian in my mix there. A bit more oil in this just to get it a little bit more buttery. It's a little bit stiff at the moment. Mm-hmm.
can't really tell what I'm doing until I put this background in, actually. That'll make a big difference. Now it's easier to see what's going on. Actually, yeah. Paper. Right. What do you think? I'm on the home stretch now. I'm trying to sort of soften these edges now, just into the background a little, because I want this flower to recede and be not as prominent, so the softer the edge, the less attention it draws. As soon as you see a sharp edge, your eye is drawn to it, so I'm trying to keep this soft. I want people's eyes to go to these two flowers, which are the focal points.
Well, I'm gonna break.
sometimes hard painting roses because they move. And when they move, all the shadows change, so you find you're constantly chasing them around the canvas. And it's impossible to keep up. Picking up a bit of the foliage here. And I haven't got much time left, so normally I'd spend more time, but we're running out of time today, so, and this is a sketch, a flower sketch, so hopefully it was worthwhile and useful to somebody.